So my opponent said that it's usually, Common Core is usually used for higher education and jobs, and it shouldn't be as hard to learn for, it's gonna be much harder for the people who are kind of slow or have disabilities, since it does help them, as you mentioned, if they aren't able to go through Common Core, and how are they able to go throughout, and like in real life. So it'd be much harder for them. He also mentioned his sources. He said 2015, 2016. It might have been true back then, but that was 2-3 years ago. It might not be as reliable. It might have changed. He also mentioned that yes, Common Core is pricey, but it should be affordable. However, there are schools that offer students to help with tuition. For example, Sarah and Newfang, in her article, Do the Arts Go Hand in Hand with Common Core? She mentioned that the arts have widely acknowledged benefits for education. They help create positive school climates and give kids a reason to show up to class where they find a passion. And then there was another one. Where they said that some of these kids are so poor that the school actually offers to pay for their lunch and their books and any materials that they need for class. So because most of these kids aren't able to pay for these things, how would they be able to pay for Common Core? And it wouldn't be as easy as he said it is, as well for the people with disabilities. Yes, they wouldn't be ignored, but it wouldn't be as easy as it would be for those who do understand it and have and are able to go through it. So in conclusion, Common Core should should not be continued because it is costly. The stress on teachers is very hard, and it does slow down students, especially those who are slow and those who do have disabilities. It wouldn't be fair to them.